Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is gonna be my February Ipsy versus Ipsy Glamac Plus. So you guys wanna see what's in both my Ipsy boxes for this month, then just keep on watching. All right, so starting off with my February Ipsy, I'm gonna assume it's gonna be like a Valentine's Day theme. I tried to go for like a Valentine's Day look today, but I feel like I look like a vampire. I don't know. I tried, y'all. So, ooh, this is furry or fuzzy or like, yeah, like felt. Okay, I really like this bag. It reminds me, it feels like a pillow basically. And let's see, I think the card is inside of here. The theme is feel the love. Yes, definitely Valentine's Day theme. And then we get some random product from a brand I've never heard. This is from YSC Collection. This is a matte bronzer in the shade Caramelo. So here's the packaging, super simple. Let's see, ooh. It looks a little reddish, orangey. I see myself wearing this more as a transition shade, as an eyeshadow, than a bronzer. It actually feels very smooth, but this is way too warm. Yeah, guys, that is definitely gonna look really orangey on me as a bronzer, but that's a really pretty eyeshadow, so I could use it as an eyeshadow. I think it also, there is like a little mirror, there's like a little protective layer on there, but this is definitely more of an eyeshadow to me. I just feel like it looks a little too reddish. It almost is like a nude blush to me, which is totally fine. I just know it's not gonna suit my complexion, but I could definitely still use it as an eyeshadow. Next up we have, oh, a product from Tula. I love Tula. It's been years since I used Tula, but I used to use their products religiously. I really love this line. This is their Purifying Cleanser. I actually really, really like this product. I've used a couple different tubes of their cleanser before. This is also a little pricier. I'm so excited about this, obviously. I love their moisturizer. I was using just Tula religiously for like a solid year or so. So I'm so excited. There's like probiotics in all of their skincare. Oh, that's exciting because I'm sure not everybody's used Tula. It's not as popular as like some brands in Sephora, but I actually like really, really love Tula. I need to get back into it because I know they've released some more products since when I used to use them. So I'm actually very excited about this because Tula is a little bit more difficult to access just because it's not available like at Ulta or Sephora or the drugstore or anything. I think it's only really available on their website and maybe like Dermstore or something. So it's a product that I like wouldn't normally go out and get otherwise, but I actually really like it. Okay, I just got like so excited about that cleanser. Next up, this is from The Balm. This says Autobalm Girl Powder. Oh, that's cute. Oh, this is a blush. Yeah, this reminds me of the, what is it called? Not the Frat Boy blush. There was definitely a blush by The Balm that I used to love that was similar to this shade, and I used to wear it all the time several years ago. This formula is just so creamy. I like this like mauve-y shade, especially during the winter time. It's super pigmented as well, so I'm gonna go in with a light hand. But this is actually a decent size, and it's like a very great formula. I know that from other blushes from The Balm. So if I get anything from The Balm, I much rather get one of their highlighters, a blush, or a bronzer, not like a random single eyeshadow. So I'm actually very happy about this. I'm definitely gonna wear this shade as well. I'm glad I got like a complexion product where the shade actually makes sense for me compared to like this really orange bronzer. All right, so next up, this is a lip fondant from the brand Half Caked. Let's see, let me open this up. I don't know if I've heard of this brand, and it's gonna be in the shade Low Key. All right, so this is what the lip color looks like. It's a little of an interesting shade. I feel like this is gonna smell like cake. It smells like absolutely nothing. With this like fruity packaging and like the sprinkles and stuff, I totally wanted it to smell like Funfetti cake, but no, it smells like nothing. I do like this shade. I don't know if this is a matte formula. Let me see what it says on the packaging because it's not, it doesn't seem to be drying very quickly. All right, so it doesn't seem to be matte, and it doesn't actually say anything other than lip fondant on the packaging. It doesn't say what kind of formula it's supposed to be, but it's been like a couple minutes and it's still, it's like kind of drying out a little bit, but it's still kind of, ooh, and it looks like I like am bleeding or something. It's not the most flattering shade, but I feel like maybe Maybe I'll wear it. I don't know. I love red lipsticks, but this one's kind of like a brick, has like a little bit of an orangey hint to it. So I don't know. Let me know if you guys have tried out that brand, because that one's like another random brand to me. And then lastly, I have, ooh, Sex Kitten. Oh, this is so cute. Sex Kitten from Tarte. This is an eyeliner, and the top of the cap is a little, there you go, it's a little cat, which is absolutely adorable. All right, so this is a liquid liner. I have a feeling I'm gonna like this. I'm actually running super low on my liquid liners right now, and I think I've tried some liquid liners from Tarte in the past. I don't think I've tried this one, but I'm definitely gonna use this. I run through my liquid liners super quickly. And this actually looks like a really nice wand as well, because some of the other ones I get in subscription boxes are like super, super thick, so you can't get a precise wing with it. So I will definitely try this one out. I think this is probably a little bit smaller than a full size. Like, it looks a little bit more mini. Let me show you. The one I used today is a little gunky, but this is the Benefit Roller Lash, yeah, so a roller liner. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure this Sex Kitten liner is smaller than a full size, but definitely still using it. I run through my eyeliner so quickly. So I actually got a decent box with specifically these three products, because these are all high-end brands that I like, products that I'm interested in. And then the duds are kind of the lipstick, more so because of the lip color, is just like not my favorite thing in the world, especially if it's not matte. I don't really like colorful lip products that are more satin. And then just this bronzer is a little bit random, and the shade is not going to be great. But other than that, I think just these three products are totally worth the bag for me, especially because they're all high value and products I'm actually going to use like on a regular basis. All right, so moving right into my Glam Bag Plus for February. Let's see. Ooh, I remember that I got to pick out a product this month in my Glam Bag Plus. I think that's been an option for a little while. I think I just wasn't seeing the emails, but I did see the email for this one, and I got to pick out one product, and this is the Wander Beauty Nude Illusion Liquid Foundation. I got the shade medium. I think there was like a couple different options that I could choose from, and hopefully this is a shade that actually works, because if that's the case, like, I'm pretty sure this is like a $40 foundation and it's totally worth it. All right, so let's check out the packaging. I think it's a wand. Yes, it is a wand foundation. Okay, there we go. I feel like this is probably, I can totally make that work. If not, like, I actually think this might actually be basically a perfect match for me. Yeah, I totally think this is a good shade for me. It looks like pretty warm as well. I'm already happy with the box just with this foundation, because I'm pretty sure it's like a $45 value. And I actually think this is gonna be like a really good match for me. I've heard a lot of good things about this foundation as well. And I really love the wand applicator. I just find it so convenient. So one of my other favorite foundations is the Pure Love Your Selfie foundation. This also has a wand applicator, and I just find that kind of applicator super convenient, because then I don't need to use a foundation brush. I can kind of basically blend out my foundation with the applicator and then just finish it off with a beauty blender. It makes it super easy. So I'm really excited about this one. I don't have a lot of products from Wander Beauty, and I definitely have been wanting to try that out. Next up, I see something from Dominique Cosmetics. This might be, yes, this is an eyeshadow palette from them. I believe this came out last fall. This is their Sweater Weather eyeshadow palette, I believe. Something like that. It looks like sweater print on the outside. This is actually an all matte palette. I don't know if I like the shades in here. So I'm actually not sure if I want to hang on to this, because I really don't need this palette. Yeah, it's basically all matte. I do love this brand, but this does not excite me much at all. So I might be passing this along. Like, the shades are totally fine, but I honestly, I wouldn't really wear anything other than this brown shade. Like, the purpley shades are a little bit more cool for me, and it's basically an all matte palette, but it's definitely still a really good value in the box, but just not my favorite from this brand. Love the brand, not really a fan of the shades. And then next up, I got a bunch of sheet masks. These are from the brand Sweet Chef. I haven't heard of this brand, but I basically have just like three sheet masks. They look cute, but I don't really get excited about these. I feel like I always get sheet masks in my subscription boxes, and they just like pile up in my bathroom and I never end up using them. All right, so next up we have a product from Il Makiage. I've heard of this brand. I feel like it's been really popping up on Instagram. I've never tried any of their products. This might be a liquid liner as well. This is called their ink liner. So I'm assuming it's gonna be like a black liquid liner. All right, so this liner also has a similar tip to the one that I got in the other box from Tarte. Yes, and it's actually like a little tiny bit shiny, but it is also very precise, so I am stocked up on liner at least until the springtime between this one and the Tarte one. I'm really excited to try that out just because I've been hearing a lot about Il Makiage. I don't know if I've actually been hearing about the products, but I just see them like all over like Instagram. I feel like I get a lot of ads from them as well. So I do want to see like what the hype is about. And then lastly is some brushes probably from La Brousse. Let's see. It's like a little envelope in here. Yeah, it's brushes. All right, so these are some face and eye brushes. Looks like some foundation brushes. A couple different brushes. All right, so we have like a flat top foundation brush, a angled foundation brush, and then some eye brushes. One of them, I don't like brushes like this. I just don't know what to do with this. Like, do I put on like a base with, I don't know what to do with this. Maybe for like concealer, but this is just like one of those brushes that I don't know what to do with it. I have some brushes like this in my collection and I never end up using them. But then we also have some like blending brushes, which is always a good thing. This is like a small tapered brush and then a flat brush. So I'll definitely use those. At least 4 out of the 5 brushes I will use for sure. Lastly, we also get a bag in the Glam Bag Plus. I actually prefer the little quilted bag that I got in my regular Ipsy. I feel like these are like the same size. Almost. Yeah, these are basically the same size. Usually the bags in the Glam Bag Plus are like double the size of the regular little Ipsy bag. But that is everything in my box. I believe that in the past, they would tell me how much the products are worth, but I got nothing in my box. Just a little love letter, but I just want details on all the prices. I do want to know how much those brushes are valued for, because that can kind of make or break the price of the box. I believe like these palettes are usually around like $35. The liquid liner is probably around like $20. The foundation is probably around $40. And then the sheet mask, they can call it $20, but it's really valued at like $8, honestly. Like, I wouldn't pay more than a couple dollars per sheet mask, but that is everything in both boxes. Honestly, the foundation totally made it for me, and I was so happy that I got to pick out my choice. I think it's just something I've been behind on because I haven't been checking my email. So I'm really excited about that, because if I get to pick out one like high-end product every month, I think that makes the box a lot more worth it, because I know that this is more expensive than the box itself, and everything else is kind of just like a perk with it too. But that is going to be everything for both boxes. I want to say like both were pretty decent. If I liked the shades in this palette, then this would be a great box, but because I don't really like the shades in here. Let me know if you guys do, but I don't really like the shades in here, so I'm kind of like taking that out of the box when I think about everything that I got. But that's gonna be everything for this unboxing. Let me know what you guys ended up getting in either Ipsy bags, or if you got an Ipsy Ultimate, let me know what you guys got in that as well. Let me know if you think it's worth it. But that's gonna be everything for today's video. If you guys liked it, make sure you give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll talk to you guys soon in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.